because of an old classmate named Felix Kane.
Felix was funny and kind, and he was great with Ratasha's daughter.
They had a great relationship. She thought that was the one.
Over time, however, Ratasha and Felix's romance hit a snag.
He couldn't hold down a job. Their financial stability becomes a strain.
Ratasha tried to help Felix get a job, but he never seemed motivated to work.
Like, we're hiring right now. I can get you an interview with the manager.
Those long hours, babe, I respect at home with you. You don't want me calling all the time, do you?
Felix, you can't just sit around all day doing nothing. I need you to contribute, Felix.
It seemed to Ratasha that Felix didn't mind being unemployed, as long as she was paying his way. And that wasn't going to work for someone as independent as Ratasha.
Their relationship started to have some problems.
Felix tried to convince her that they could make things work, that he had real feelings for her, but Ratasha ended the relationship.
As a mother, she realized that she couldn't have that instability in her life.
Having children to look after, that really puts her in a very different place about what her future should look like.
After the breakup, Ratasha refocused her attention on her daughter.
Ratasha's family is saying this person she was with for several years, the relationship ended badly.
They thought she'd actually been hearing from her ex-boyfriend Felix and that he was wanting to get back together with her.
Apparently Felix still had those feelings there and didn't want to let her go.
Maybe Felix had arranged to meet up with Ratasha at the motel and things hadn't worked out the way he hoped.
Detectives suspect that might be the case when they bring Felix in for an interview.
The first thing that the detectives note is that Felix matches the description of the guy on camera. He has the same height and build.
And what Felix tells detectives raises even more suspicion.
Where were you Halloween night?
I was at home. Can anyone verify that?
No. I was home, alone, just taking it easy.
He says that he was at home watching horror movies.
Without any witnesses, there was basically no way to confirm or deny his location at the time of Ratasha's murder.
But Felix insists he had nothing to do with Ratasha's death.
Felix tells detectives that not only would he never hurt her, but he was trying to get back together with her.
He doesn't deny the fact that he still had feelings for Ratasha, and in fact said that she had seemed amenable to possibly rekindling their relationship and that they had gone and had coffee together to talk about things.
Maybe she and Felix were at a place of being able to reconcile and rekindle that romance.
He wanted to heal their relationship and make amends.
According to Felix, though, it was Ratasha who needed healing.
Felix told detectives that the last time he had run into Ratasha at the restaurant, it looked like she had been roughed up pretty bad.
Are you okay?
Felix said that he noticed Ratasha had bruises and he was concerned about it.
Okay. Ratasha may have been the victim of domestic abuse only days earlier.
Ratasha's ex-boyfriend Felix told detectives that the last time he saw her, he noticed she had a black eye.
What happened?
Oh, this is nothing. I just hit myself on a car, that's all.
Are you sure?
Felix tells police that when he asked her about it, she was kind of hesitant to tell him what had happened.
That is very difficult to talk about, even with your most trusted confidant.
Felix claims that Ratasha had eventually told him the truth.
Felix told detectives that Ratasha admitted that it was her boyfriend Jarvis who had gotten physical with her, and that's why she had bruising.
According to Felix, Jarvis had supposedly choked Ratasha.
Apparently, he's been getting increasingly violent with her over the course of her relationship.
And she said that this guy had choked her.
That's what she said.
Felix's claims are telling, especially when detectives get the results of Ratasha's autopsy.
The medical examiner noticed bruising on her neck, He noticed petechiae around her eyes, blood in her stomach.
She lost her life due to asphyxiation.
After talking to Felix, detectives follow up with Rotasha's family.